Right, here we have all the parts that we'll need to make up our suspension arms. When making up all your various components, it is always best to do it as a production run. That is, make up one particular unit, all the quantity that you need, so you can tool up and set all your cutting guides and jigs the same. It's a lot quicker and it's a lot easier to produce multiple parts. You will be required to be able to cut, drill and weld steel. The purpose of this video is not to show you how to do that. What I will be doing is, I will be going through and showing how each part fits to the other. The first step is to assemble the idler arm pivot boss. Now what I have here is an 1¼-inch large nut, scrounged around scrap yards and found these. And the inside diameter clearance on the thread is 27mm. And I happened to find a piece of pipe that was 27mm that will fit nicely into there. Now, this nut is 23.5mm thick. And I need an overall thickness of 27mm. So I have a 1-inch washer. It's 3.5mm thick, that will be added onto the base of this with the sleeve fitted in like so. Here we have the washer. I've had to file the washer out just a little bit because it's a 1-inch washer, so that'll fit. Then I fit the nut over the sleeve, and what I'll do is I'll weld the sleeve level with the top of the nut, and I'll weld the washer onto the faces of the nut here. And there will be two of these units that I will make up. Right, now we've finished doing those two bosses, right, we'll now put those aside and concentrate on our suspension arm pivot boss. Again, a large nut, but this nut is 25mm deep here, as opposed to our final finished one here at 27.
The reason there is a difference in the thickness of each of the bosses is due to the alignment of the mounting brackets on the hull. The idler arm boss is mounted to a 3mm suspension brace, whilst the road wheel suspension boss is mounted to a 5mm brace. As you can see, the difference in the thickness is there to maintain the correct alignment of all suspension arms.
What we have here is the same setup. We've cut some more lengths of tube that'll slip just inside. There's a neat fit. You might have to hammer these down as it's a bit firm. Now we have 10 of these to do, so we'll do those much the same as these, and then I'll show you the next step. Now with our suspension arm boss and idler arm bosses cleaned up, now what we have here is 50mm long by 21.6mm, or just a fraction under 7/8 of an inch. Same bushings as we use on the road wheels. Now we place those in so that they protrude 25mm from the inside face of our boss, suspension arm boss with the bushing. And what we have here is the actual suspension arm. It's made from rectangular steel tubing, 50mm by 25mm, or 2 inches by 1 inch, with a wall thickness of 2.5mm. It's quite strong, sturdy, and easy to work with. We have a 7/8-inch hole drilled this end and a 5/8 hole drilled that end. Just check the drawings for the exact dimensions and layout. What I'll be doing is that I will be welding the boss to one side of the suspension arm so that one face is level with the rad. With this end radded, it allows me to actually get the welding electrode down deep inside to weld our bushing on both inside faces, and we will also weld the nut in place right round to the inside face of our suspension arm. Once we've completed the weld for the boss to the suspension arm, I've made up some capping made from 2-inch water pipe, which is a 60mm outside diameter, that will actually fit over the top like so and cap this end. Now that I've welded the boss to 10 of these suspension arms, I just put those aside for the time being, and we're going to look at two more suspension arms which are the same except that they will not have the boss on them. I've welded through the bushing the same as the others. Fitting a small arm so the whole thing is like a bell crank. So this will act now as a boss. Now we have to start thinking in left and right. Basically going to have to be a mirror copy of each other. This lever is welded on so it's square to our suspension arm. But before I do, I'm going to reinforce this open area here by welding a flat bar to it all the way right round. With the two other bushes that we've made up, the ones with the actual washers welded to the base of them, we now will fit a shorter arm, and this is the return idler arm. And we'll do this the same as we did the main suspension arms. Let's recap what we've done. We have welded our bosses to our suspension arms, cranks to our two front suspension arms, and our bosses to the idler return arms. Next step is to fit the wheel axles. What I have here is a 7 inch by 5/8 inch hex bolt, which will act as our axle for our road wheels. And it's quite a simple process. What we do is we take our suspension arm, and on the face that has the actual boss, we place the bolt through. It may be a bit tight, so you'll have to tap these in. Next off is just weld the head of the bolt to the inside face of our suspension arm. With our crank arms, same thing applies. Where the crank is, that's the inside, and remember that is the side that you place your bolt. The idler arm, again the same. Face with the boss is the face that you actually have to place the bolt through. Now you'll find that most bolts of this size have a slight meniscus or fillet on the inside of the head. To enable our bolt to fit in neatly, you may have to just countersink this hole to around about 0.5 to 1 millimetre, depending on the bolt that you have, so it will fit in neatly.
Right now, carry on and weld the heads of the bolts to the suspension arms, and I'll catch you later.